Hello guys and welcome to another episode of Drum Talk. Here and there I got some requests about the option of a footboard or pedal-based trigger system for the Dubbins. And to be honest, I was working on something about a year ago. Then I noticed that the guy from, I think, the Czech Republic, Andre, was working on a pretty similar idea like mine. So I stopped developing my idea because he was way further than me and focused more on other projects. His product is called OnTrigger and is available now for a couple of months ago, and it turns out to be working pretty good. So I reached out to him and I got my own kit. So in this video I like to show you how the kit looks like, what's all included, and of course how the installation works on the Darwin, and it's pretty similar on most other pedals. So let's go. So here we have the OnTriggers. It comes in the standard box with some stickers, a detailed manual, so it shows you exactly how the trigger is supposed to be mounted and also shows you some bad examples or incorrect versions. Then we have, this is the double pedal version, so it comes with two footboard triggers and some zip tires for mounting the cables. Then this version also includes a spare trigger and some foot stoppers you can place on the trigger to prevent the footboard from hitting on the trigger too hard in case it's not attached to a bass drum or a practice pad, and an Allen key for readjusting the trigger once it's mounted and if you change your settings. So I'm gonna just grab a dummy, rearrange the camera angle and be right back. So I just ran through the manual and it explains pretty good how you get the best results out of the sensor. Basically what you can see is that the sensor over here is placed on this angled plate, which is attached with some screws to a base plate, which has some tape to place it underneath the footboard on the base plate. What you need to do is to make sure that the sensor lines up most parallel with the footboard once the beater touches the drum head. In my case it would be over here, so the sensor already looks pretty parallel in my example. And most important is that the sensor is only supposed to be touched very slightly. So a bad example would be to place the trigger way far to the back, so the impact would be way too high, or if you would place it very much to the front where it doesn't get any contact, or you need to put the trigger in a different angle where it would only touches on one edge, which would damage the sensor. So the best case is the middle way, where it just touches the sensor slightly and you will get the best result. So once you found the correct place, make sure that the base plate is clean. Mark the position with a pen. Get rid of this safety tape off the tape, and you can place it underneath the footboard where you marked it, and that's it. If you misplaced it a little bit, you can always bend this plate by hand. Or you can take an Allen key and rearrange it a little bit with these screws so you make sure that you get the best result. And that's it, you're almost good to go. In the last step you can use the zip tires to rearrange the cable and move it to a position where it doesn't get in the way with anything else. Just make sure that you don't bend it over sharp edges or bend the cable itself hard, because you would damage it in the long term. The cool thing is that the whole system works pretty simple, and also it is protected in between the footboard and the base plate, so you can just put it in your case and you don't have to worry about damaging it. Of course it works with any regular drum module. Most of you guys I think use the TM2 for just bass drum triggers, so you can just connect it and you will get straight away a pretty good signal. That's it with this video. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. If you have any triggered related questions, I think the best way is to reach out to Andre. I will link both pages, his homepage and the Facebook page of On Triggers, in the description, so feel free to reach out to him. Until then, have a nice day and see you soon. Cheers!